Just one last point about Origins. What's up? I'm Jonathan and welcome to Maker Tales, where I'm sharing my Maker journey to help you go further in yours. So don't forget to subscribe and hit that little bell icon to never miss an opportunity to keep making. This video is all about one last little bit of information about origin points. I didn't cover it before because you didn't know movement in detail yet. But now that you do, I think it's about time we cover this point. So here we are on a nice fresh Blender file. So let's delete the things that I don't want in here because I just want to keep this nice and clean. It should be a short video. I'm covering concepts more than anything that now I can show you because we understand movement in a lot deeper understanding. And now you can implement that information into this. So I told you we cannot move the origin point without the 3D cursor. That's a lie in reality. There are other ways of moving the origin point. But the key thing to know here is in Tool, Transform, there is effect only. Now, these are some pretty interesting settings to play around with. And there is origin, location, and parents. We are not going to cover parents in this one. We'll only be covering origins and locations. So let's straight away get into it. Origins has a shortcut, which is control point. So we'll do control point, and you'll see that our origin point now has a gizmo on it. We can't affect with this gizmo, but what we can do is hit G for our moving. So we're going to grab, and because we only have origins, affect only origins, it's only going to move the origin. So now we know with a movement, we can constrain it to different planes and different axes, and we can also turn on snapping. So we'll turn on vertex snapping, and then when we do G, we can also hold down control to do a control snap to vertices. And here's something really interesting. We can actually turn on our CAD transforms, and CAD transforms, when we do our G command, there is actually one here for origin with O. So with O, we can now click our origin point, move it with CAD transforms. We can go ahead and do a Shift F for face centers, and we can snap it down to the bottom here. So this is something really powerful to be able to move your origin point with precision millimeter accuracy. So that there is the effect only origins, and to get out of there, we go with control dot once again, or you can click it on and off there. Okay, with that covered, let's quickly cover locations as well. So let's do a duplicate of this cube and move it on the y-axis a little bit. And we know what happens when we move an object. So for instance, I'm going to set my 3D cursor to the world origin. I'm going to set my main pivot point to the 3D cursor. So now it won't be using the origin point of this cube. So when we rotate on, I've got CAD transforms on. Let me go into Blender. When we rotate here now, we're going to rotate around our 3D cursor. If I constrain it to the Z, you will see this is how we expect the rotation to happen, because that 3D cursor is the pivot point, and we're going to go like that. But what happens if for some reason we wanted the face of this cube not to change when we're turning around this cube? Well, there is a way of doing that, and that is using location. So we turn this one here to affect only locations, which means when we do transform, be it a scale or rotation or a move, that scaling and rotation of the object will not be affected. So now, doing that exact same thing, if we do a rotation, constrain it to the Z, you're going to see the difference. You see the difference how the face of the cube is now staying facing without rotating anymore. So that is one last thing that I wanted to show you. And with that covered, you pretty much have everything that you need to know about transforms within Blender. All of this, both the locations and origins, effect only options, work with CAD transforms. And honestly, there's far too much to show the different ways this can be applied, but I really encourage you to play around with it. And with those points covered, it pretty much covers almost everything you need to know about origin points within a precision workflow. Of course, there's always going to be more. A huge thank you to my patrons. You guys are absolutely awesome, and it really does mean the world to me. It's the real reason I can do videos like this. And if you're enjoying the content that I'm making here, and you think that I'm worthy of your support, I would love to see you there too. Don't forget that we have a Discord, and it's linked down in the description. Thank you for watching, keep making, and let the quest continue.